Hi, everybody. Thanks for coming. I'm Brendan Smith, Arts and Humanities Coordinator for the City of Tacoma Park, and this is the latest event in our Tacoma Park Arts Cultural Series, which includes lectures, art exhibitions, film screenings, great concerts, and if you didn't pick up a brochure on your way in, you can grab one on your way out. We also have news about all our events on tacomaparkmd.gov/arts. Next Thursday at 7:30 p.m. to celebrate Black History Month, we're going to have a screening of 3 vintage civil rights films, which should be really great. And this is going to be great. We're really excited to have Yasmin Williams here with us tonight. So thank you all.
Hey, guys. Thank you so much for coming. So, this is cool. I'm happy to be here. I've never been here before, so this is super nice. Oh.
How do I turn it on?
Check, check. Good? Okay. Hey, guys. So, I think I should start this show off with a song that I really enjoy since it is Black History Month. It's by a black female guitarist, Elizabeth Cotton. I don't know if anyone's familiar with her. Yeah, she's great. If you're not familiar with her, get familiar. She's super cool. She's a really awesome folk guitarist and one of the few women guitarists that I know of anyway. But yeah. Can everyone hear that? Cool. This song is called Vestapool. Thank you, guys. Now, probably nothing else tonight is going to sound remotely like that. So this next one's called On a Friday Night. Funnily enough, it's a Friday night tonight. And I originally wrote this, like, I don't even know, like 4 years ago in my college dorm room when I was a freshman because I was sad and alone and had nothing to do, and it was a Friday night. So I wrote music. Things got better eventually, but that was a pretty sad time. Can I get some more guitar in my monitor? Also, before I forget, I have a lot of stuff up here. This thing I'm going to use in the song is called an angle. Like, I Googled guitar hammer, I think, to find it because I wanted something that gives it, like, the guitar, like, a super nice, like, metallic sound, and this was the first result. So if anyone wants one. I don't even know if they're still made, but it's called the Engel. Probably not helpful. Thank you. So you probably noticed that kind of play in a funky way. I guess I should explain. So I started playing guitar like almost 11 years ago now. Wow. because I beat the video game Guitar Hero 2. I don't know if anyone like knows the game or has kids who've played, or have you played? Yes, and Rock Band? Yeah, I have both of those, but I beat Guitar Hero 2 on expert level. So I begged my parents to get me like an actual electric guitar, and they did. And I was pretty bad for a while because I was trying to play a lot like the songs in the game are very rock oriented, like a lot of like super tapping and like shredding, and I can't really do that. So I stopped playing electric and I switched to acoustic, and I'm a lot better at this, and it's more fun, I think, because you get to like tap it and beat it. Do whatever. And I figured out I'm a lot better at tapping with the guitar in my lap like this than tapping like, I can't really do that, any of that. So I don't even know how I was good at the game, because that's all the game is. But things worked out. So the next song I'm gonna play is in the conventional, I guess, method. And it's called Song for Alex. Side note, I wrote Song for Alex for my friend Alex's birthday because I forgot to get him an actual gift. So I thought the song would be good enough. I guess I'll let y'all be the judge of that. Thank you. Are the monitors working? Can you turn guitar up? I'm hearing like this weird boom. Yeah. Why? There we go. Cool. Okay. So this next one is called Skippin'. I also wrote this for another friend's birthday, not because I forgot a gift. She likes music, so I wrote her. Well, I was also late with this. Maybe I forgot. I don't even remember. But anyway, she liked it. So this is called Skippin'. And yeah, so if you haven't noticed, I have two different shoes on. I have one tap shoe and one regular-ish shoe. I will use the tap shoe in this one. Basically, I use the tap shoe whenever my hands get really busy and I can't do any percussive stuff with my right hand. So I just resort to my feet. Whatever works, right?
Thank you.
So since it's Black History Month, I thought I'd include a rap cover. Also, I really like this song. It's by Post Malone. I don't know if anyone knows. Yeah? Yeah, cool. So it's called Sunflower. It was in the movie, the animated Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, I think it was called movie, which is a super great movie. And this is one of the few covers I actually like to play, so I kind of like to play it a lot. So here it is. Can I get a little more guitar on the monitor? So this next one's called The Missing Piece. Also, I will have merch, like CDs and stickers, after the concert outside if anyone's interested. And most of the songs I'm playing tonight are original. So this next one is on my first album called Unwind. I'm working on my second album right now. Man, okay, so that's a discussion. So I'm trying to teach myself how to play the kora. Does anyone know? Yes? Wow, that's a first. That's cool. So yeah, my kora has 21 strings and I don't know how to play. I mean, okay. I figured out a couple songs, but it's very difficult. more difficult than I thought it would be. But yeah, I figured out how to play some songs and I'm gonna include that on my second album. And also this, I got a harp guitar. So imagine this. But six more sub bass strings that kind of go like over here. So that's a journey. I got that a couple weeks ago. I don't know how to play that yet, but it will be on the album. And yeah, Like, I don't even know how to tune it, really. But I'm figuring it out. But yeah, I'm super excited for this next one. I'm kind of stretching myself. So I'm going to include, like, both of my kalimbas, my tap shoe, this guitar, my harp guitar, my kora. I was teaching myself banjo as well, but that's not going to be on the album. It doesn't fit the vibe. But anyway. And I'll play some songs that are going to be on there tonight. But this next one is called The Missing Piece, and that's on my first album called Unwind. Back to this thingy. This next one's called High Five. side note, I don't really name any of my songs. And funny story with this name. I played it in college in one of my collegium classes, and my friend came up to me and was like, he gave me a high five and was like, that reminded me of the song you just played, so I named it High Five. Or well, he named it High Five technically, but I've only ever named like three of my songs. So I think I'll use this now. That's one of my kalimbas, or some people call them thumb pianos, but don't call them that, because that's not really the correct name. yeah, so this one's just in a different key from my other one. I think it sounds pretty nice. This next song is called Through the Woods, and it's going to be on my second album, which I hope to release in early September or early October.
Thank you.
So I think I play another one that's going to be on the second album. This one's called I Wonder. The song was originally about Trump. once you hear it, you're going to be like, how? But that's kind of what I was thinking about. Or like, I guess I was wondering what direction our country was going to go in after his presidency. But I'll probably dedicate it to something else because I don't really want him to have anything to do with my music. Thank you.
Thank you.
I mean, like, that doesn't even sound like it's about Trump. Right. Thank you. So this song might also be on the second album. Fun fact, I wrote this for a fan of mine's birthday because a friend of theirs reached out to me on Instagram and was like, hey, write a song for my friend's birthday. He's a big fan of yours. I was like, okay. But I procrastinated for like a week. So the day before the party, I wrote this. I was like, well, I should have given myself more time, but it actually came out pretty nice. So it's untitled, I guess. It might be called birthday song. I don't know. It's untitled right now. If anyone has any ideas, let me know. I think that was pretty good for like 24 hours. It's all right. So I guess, it's already 9:00. I guess I'll play a couple more. Should I play one this way or I'll let you guys. Both? Okay. Wait, like a flip? I've done that three. No. Okay, one of each. Fine. Yes, that works. Like, side note, it's super kind of like weird and weirdly difficult to like swap from this to this and back up. It takes some coordination, I guess, which I don't really have, but I make it work. So, actually, I'll use my other kalimba now. So this song is called Gitka, and this song was the first song I wrote using a kalimba. I originally got the idea from, I don't know, like, well, most people know Earth, Wind, and Fire, right? But yeah, Maurice White used a kalimba in a lot of his live performances, and the solos were really cool. So I've always wanted one since I was a kid, and I finally found one in Guitar Center with no price tag, and it was the last one. So I snagged that. And I still really don't know how to play it correctly, since you're not supposed to really tape it. Like, I put tape on the back and just stick it on and use my fingers to play. You're supposed to use your thumbs, but I don't know what that is. So I play like that. And this song was the first song that I also used a tap shoe. So I was just going all out, I guess, on this one. It worked out. So this one's called Gitka. Can you guys hear that? Cool. Thank you. So I'll play a couple more. So you guys want another one up, okay. And I'll add in a flip one too, just to be. So the next song I'm gonna play is called New Beginnings, and I wrote it right before I started college, since I went to school at NYU in New York City, and I'd never even been to New York City before, so that was like super intense, so I wrote a song about it. Fun fact about this was featured in Acoustic Guitar Magazine last year, and my guitar was just featured in the latest issue, which was actually pretty cool. It's a nice guitar, I guess. Yeah, it was built by Skytop Guitars, and I love it. If anyone has any questions about anything, also, like, feel free to, like, talk to me after. Like, I'm approachable. Here's my last trick. So I'm just, it's not really much. It's just a cello bow, and I use it, well, I just play like one note with it, but it sounds cool. It's basically, I got the idea from a band called Sigur Rós. I don't know if anyone knows. Hey, yeah, so I can't do what he does. But, right, disappointing. But I can make it sound good on one string. Basically, the lead guitarist and singer plays electric guitar, and he bows his guitar, all of the strings, and it sounds great. I can't do that, so I just use it as a drone, basically. But yeah, this last one's called Restless Heart. Thank you guys so much for coming. I really appreciate it. I hope you guys have enjoyed the music. Thank you. But yeah, this one's called Restless Heart. Thank you. Thank you guys very much. So, yeah, I'll have merch. Come hang, come or not. I mean, whatever. Thank you guys for coming.